The psychological thriller The Devil All the Time is the kind of movie that'll linger in your mind for quite a while once the credits finish rolling. And that's, of course, largely thanks to its talented cast. Take, for instance, actress Riley Keough, who plays the beautiful but devious Sandy Henderson. Keough has made her name in quiet, suspenseful indies and terrifying horror movies. But she's also broken out in bigger movies, too. Here's why she looks so familiar. Riley Keough has a knack for playing characters who appear to be victims, but know more than they let on, and have a sinister streak. See, for example, her role in The Discovery. Starring Robert Redford, Rooney Mara, and Jason Segel, it's a science fiction drama about a man named Thomas Harbour, who believes he's proved the existence of an afterlife. Keough's character Lacey works for Harbour, but she's not exactly a model employee.
I'm sorry.
Her character in Hold the Dark also hides a dangerous streak. Keough plays Medora, the mother of a child who has gone missing in a tiny Alaskan village. When wolf behavior expert Russell Core arrives to investigate at Medora's request, he quickly realizes that Medora has more information than she's willing to share.
So you come to kill it? To kill the one that took him?
If horror is your go-to genre, you may know Keough from her role in several Sleep with the Lights On terror fests.
Hey.
Sorry, you scared me.
In 2017, Keough played Kim in It Comes at Night. She's a member of one of two families who end up sharing a remote cabin while trying to escape a highly contagious virus that has taken over the world. In 2020, Keough took on another character trapped in a less than cozy cabin with less than welcoming inhabitants in The Lodge. This time, she played a woman with a dark past who snowed in with her fiancé's two children in a remote house. Keough moved from psychological horror to all-out gore for 2018's The House That Jack Built. Jack is a serial killer and torturer, now dead and recounting his crimes in hell. Keough plays one of his victims. It's an understatement to say that her character meets a gruesome end. Hopefully, you didn't watch this one over dinner. When Riley Keough makes romantic dramas, they tend to come with a twist. For example, in 2012's Jack and Diane, she and Juno Temple play the titular couple. And although the love story is sincerely heartfelt, there's a supernatural current running beneath it. Keough fans might also like the thriller Earthquake Bird. Released in 2019, it centers around a love triangle that turns deadly. It's not just romance Keough is reinterpreting. In 2017, she starred alongside Catherine Keener and the late great Anton Yelchin in We Don't Belong Here. At first, it appears to be your standard dysfunctional family indie drama, but it soon turns into a thriller. If you prefer movies that blend the wacky with the depraved, you may also remember Keough from her impressive role in Under the Silver Lake. If your idea of a perfect movie is one that makes you feel like you've been on an emotional roller coaster by the end, there's a good chance you've seen Keough in at least a couple of those too. In 2016, Keough played the leader of a gang of young misfits in American Honey, which also starred Shia LaBeouf. The movie's narrative follows the group as they travel the US in a beaten-up van, scraping by selling magazine subscriptions. The film's loose feel reflects the filming process. American Honey was made as part of a 7-week road trip for $3.5 million, with the actors getting their dialogue on the day they shot each scene. Although Keough has avoided conventional rom-coms, she's appeared in two indie romances. In Love Song, her character Sarah and Jenna Malone's Mindy play old friends who become something more on a road trip. And in Dixieland, she plays a stripper who lives next door to an ex-con who, like Keough's Rachel, is looking to escape their sleepy Mississippi town. Riley Keough has appeared in multiple projects helmed by filmmaker Steven Soderbergh. Possibly the most widely known is 2012's Magic Mike, starring Matthew McConaughey and Channing Tatum. Keough and Tatum reunited in another Soderbergh project in 2017, playing siblings in NASCAR heist comedy Logan Lucky. Adam Driver rounded out the Logan family, and Daniel Craig also starred as a platinum blonde, mildly unhinged safecracker.
You Logans mustn't be as simple-minded as people say.
People say that?
If you're sure you know Keough from somewhere else, but are more into TV than movies, it could be that you watched her lead the first season of The Girlfriend Experience. Keough starred as a law student and intern whose side gig is working as a high-end escort, a performance that earned her a Golden Globe nomination. Soderbergh executive produced the series and also directed the movie for which it's named. Even when Riley Keough appears in projects that you could call mainstream, she picks ones that are a step or two outside the expected. For example, Keough appeared in a third season episode of the dark, offbeat teen drama Riverdale. Her character Lori apprehends Archie and Jughead when they try to sneak into her family's farm. Although they're initially able to talk her into letting them stay, it doesn't go well for the pair. Finally, if dystopian science fiction with car chases and loud music is more your thing, you may remember Keough for her role as the wife capable in Mad Max Fury Road. If you've seen the film, you won't be surprised to learn that Keough described the shoot as the craziest thing she's ever experienced. Fortunately, she's not one to shy away from a role that challenges viewers, and it pays off. Thanks for watching. Click the links in our video to watch more from Netflix Film Club. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.